Well, here at NUI Galway, one of the things we do, which is quite unique and different from any other university in the Republic, is we combine sociology and political science. They're usually separate subjects. We fuse the two together. What that actually means in your first year programme, if you're doing the arts degree and one of the denominated degrees in arts, you have the option of doing Sauk and Paul, political science, sociology, one of the most popular subjects in first year. What you actually study is we start with a study of political systems in Ireland, the party system, elections. We move quickly on to the study of religion, education, crime and deviance. It's a survey course. After Christmas, we move on to the study of the isms, nationalism, socialism, liberalism, so you get to know your isms in this course. And finally, we end the course with the study of economic changes, the post-Celtic Tiger, what's going on in social change, Ireland becoming a multicultural, much more diverse type of society. So that's actually what you study here. The second year programme breaks into individual courses, and we tend to match very evenly the sociology with the politics. You'll be studying courses, for instance, I lecture on European politics in second year. There's also courses in political sociology, but highly applied courses like child policy, what's happening in international child policy. So the department tries to mix in theoretical courses, courses which study particular regions like Europe, but also highly applied things. Finally, in third year, we give you the option of specialising on a particular area. You can do a small class with an individual lecturer, and you can, in a small group, explore a topic in much more depth. For instance, we have topics on Mexican politics, topics on American politics, topics on environmental issues, all sorts of very detailed issues, which really you only study when you get into your third year. Most students really like the opportunity to take a small issue and study it with a smaller group of students in much more depth. I would say this is a very accessible and open subject in both first year, second year and third year. It's extremely popular, and that shows you that many students both do take it, find it interesting and can cope with it. The main requirement, I would say, like many of the art subjects, would be a curiosity about the world, society, politics. That doesn't mean that you have to be, you know, an expert on the latest election or something like that in detail. But I think a curiosity and an openness would allow you to kind of get into the subject and get interested in it. Having an interest in the subject is absolutely essential. There's no detailed prerequisite subjects that you have to have studied at the Leaving Cert to go and do this subject. It's a very accessible, very doable subject, and I think clearly a lot of students find it very rewarding. As regards job opportunities, quite a few of our graduates end up in careers in politics, journalism, media, and in the civil service and public administration. We have quite a few very notable graduates in the world of public affairs, politics and things like that. But many of our graduates have gone on to also careers in diverse areas, like in a business and in the cultural realm and in media and things like that. So it's not necessarily a subject that will lead to a deliberate career, but it is a subject that can feed in, like all the art subjects, to a wide range of career paths. Maybe the only exception to that I would suggest is if you think about some of our graduate programmes, where we have highly applied master's programmes in the area of social work and in the area of family support, which works with the HSE. These are highly applied, also the community development masters, and a significant number of our graduates have taken the subject and brought it that way, making it a very kind of highly applied social policy type of career, where you're either working for the HSE, you're working for charities like Trocra, or you're working for other NGOs, taking your social and political knowledge and making it work, so to speak, in that sector of the economy and society.